singing number 598, Sing the Hindu Song.
Thank you. according to your good pleasure, that in the name of your beloved Son, we may act in good works. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the book of the prophet Jonah. The word of the Lord came to Jonah, saying, "Set out for the great city of Nineveh and announce to it the message that I will tell you." So Jonah made ready and went to Nineveh, according to the Lord's bidding. Now Nineveh was an enormously large city. It took 3 days to go through it. Jonah began his journey throughout through the city and had gone but a single day's walk, announcing, 40 days more and Nineveh shall be destroyed. When the people of Nineveh believed God, they proclaimed a fast, and all of them, great and small, put on sackcloth. When God saw by their actions how they turned from their evil way, He repented them. He repented of the evil that he had threatened to do to them. He did not carry it out. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. I tell you, brothers and sisters, the time is running out. From now on, let those having wives act as not having them. Those weeping as not weeping. Those rejoicing as not rejoicing. Those buying as not owning. those using the world as not using it fully. For the world in its present form is passing away. The word of the Lord.
Brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. After John had been arrested, Jesus came to Galilee proclaiming the gospel of God. This is the time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. As he passed by the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting their nets into the sea. They were fishermen. Jesus said to them, "Come after me, and I will make you fishers of men." Then they abandoned their nets and followed him. He walked along a little farther and saw James, the son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They too were in a boat mending their nets. Then he called them. So they left their father Zebedee in the boat, along with the hired men, and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord. Today on this Sunday, this weekend of the Word of God, a feast that was declared just a few years ago by Pope Francis, we are reminded of the need to, and here I quote, celebrate, study, and disseminate the Word of God. Being a relatively new feast for us, the Word, we in fact may lose sight of it and lose track of it because it's in with so many of the larger feasts. But the emphasis on the words of the gospel, the words of God, the words of scripture and their importance is something that we must address. So let's do just that. Let's focus on some of the more important words in today's scripture readings. Starting off, we have a number of words in the English language that come from the Greek word for time, chronos. There is chronology, chronicle, chronometry, and even chronic, which refers to something that lasts for a long time. Chronos tells us what time it is. For example, it's January the 20th or 21st. Who knows what time it is? I take off my watch before I begin the Mass. But it's that data that we need in order to continue with our work and be here on time and make our appointments when we have them set up. However, the Greeks had a second word for time, which was kairos. Kairos meant another kind of time, which we might call occasion or opportunity. It tells us what time is for. It's what a mother might say when she tells her child, "It's time for you to get working on your homework." Or how we might be thinking, "It's time for spring to come." After arriving here today, I'm sure that's on many of our minds.
Some people might even be thinking here now, it's time to get this homily over with so that we can get home and watch TV or whatever it is that we're going to do this evening. I'm sure that doesn't pertain to any of the people that are here. In our first reading, it was time for the people of Nineveh to reform their lives and do penance. In the second reading, St. Paul tells us time is running out. Clearly, he was encouraging the Corinthian community to be detached from the things of this world, even marital love, because he expected the second coming of Christ and the end of the world to happen in a very short time. As we all know, it didn't happen that way, certainly not the way that they expected it to. However, even though we do not know when it will happen, Paul's basic idea remains absolutely true. We must not get so preoccupied with our everyday concerns that we forget about the life that is to come, the true life for which we were created. My brothers and sisters, salvation is not automatic for us. We don't have forever to get ourselves ready for it. It's not just old people who die. I know from my own experience that death can come to anyone at any time. In fact, the only thing we can build our lives on that is reliable and that is permanent is the life we hope to enjoy with God for all eternity. Jesus tells us the same thing. Here I quote, "This is the time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel." That last part sounds familiar. That's what we use on Ash Wednesday. You'll be hearing that in just about a month or so when the ashes are placed on your forehead. That's one of the two possible things that are said when the ashes are being placed. This is where that comes from. Jesus used the word kairos when he said, "This is the time. Now is the opportunity to open ourselves to God's life and what God is calling forth from us. Now is the season to open ourselves to him." By the way, this is the third of the new mysteries that the Holy Father added to the rosary called the Mysteries of Light. Jesus' call for conversion. You may have heard it in the midst of your praying the rosary. And this call is not just a message for other people to hear. Conversion is ongoing. We all sin. We all tend to get lazy. We all tend to get our priorities out of order at times and put aside the more important things for things that are easier or more fun. And we all have room to grow more in our faith. Jesus makes that very clear throughout the scriptures as well. My brothers and sisters, I'm sure we all understand opportunities do not hang around forever. So it is now, not tomorrow, not when I turn 85 or 90 years old. Now is the time for me and for you to open our lives more and more and more to Jesus and to the gospel message, to the Lord's good news. Perhaps the Lord is inviting us, as he did Peter and Andrew, James and John, to help get this message out to all people, to others. After all, you don't have to be a priest or religious to do this. Although right now we can certainly use a few more good priests, deacons, and religious. Whoever you are, you can pray for the conversion of someone, or you can perhaps even do more to help someone come into the presence of the Lord. So then, the next time you look at your watch or your smartphone, as the case may be, don't just see what time it is. Thank God for the precious gift of time, of life, and ask yourself, are you using it the best you can? Oh, and we couldn't do better than exactly what we are doing here as we gather for Mass. What we are doing right now, praying the most perfect prayer that there is, the Mass itself. We need to remember that it's one continuous prayer of thanksgiving to our loving God. Listen to the different pieces of it. We went into great detail not too far back to introduce or to remind you of what it is that's taking place up here each time we gather. Most important of all, the presence of Jesus that we will be receiving is to strengthen us as we continue to grow in our love for him and then reach out with that love to those around us. It all comes together here within the framework of being gifted by God with life, with time, with whatever talents and skills he has given to each of us. I can't help but think one of the things that one of my favorite sayings is, I discovered it on one of those signboards back around 20, 25 years ago. Every day is a gift from God. That's why it's called the present. If you need something to take with you that you'll think of, perhaps in the midst of your daily routine, think of that and remind yourself. Jesus is available to you, that's his promise. The gifts of the Holy Spirit are available to you as well, thanks to what Jesus did by sending the Holy Spirit to be here in our midst. And most important and precious, we will be receiving the very body and blood of Jesus in just a few moments here at this altar. That is what strengthens us in our resolve to become all that God created us to be without any limitations that we may be putting on it ourselves. We will have what we need. That's the promise of Jesus. All we need to do is work to take him up on his promise.
Kingdom of God is at hand, and witness to the presence of Christ in our lives, we pray to the Lord. That those in power may exercise wisdom and mercy in ensuring that justice is pursued in every case, at every opportunity, we pray to the Lord. That society may grow steadfast in protecting the dignity of all human life from conception to natural death, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have chosen a life of ministry, following in the footsteps of Jesus, that they may bear much fruit. We pray to the Lord. For those who have died, especially those for whom this Mass is being offered, and Hazel Butler, we pray to the Lord. For couples who long for children who long to have a family, and for those bearing new life, we pray to the Lord. For all the prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts. And for all our intentions, spoken and unspoken, we pray to the Lord.
My brothers and sisters, I now invite you to pray with me the prayer for religious vocations, which you will find inside the front of the tree. Let us pray for vocations.
O God, we honestly beseech thee to bless the church with many priests, deacons, brothers, and sisters who will love you with their whole strength, be faithful to their vocation, and gladly spend their entire lives to teach your truths, serve your church, and make you known and loved.
Bless our families, bless our children.
Choose from our homes those who are needed for your work. Pray for us. Pray for our priests, deacons, seminarians, and religious. Obtain for us many more. Amen.
As we send us in the word of Christian and Zion, number 345:22.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at my hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Accept our offerings, O Lord, we pray, and in sanctifying them, grant that they may profit us for salvation. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Dennis, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. My sisters and brothers, at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us now offer each other some sign Christ's peace. Brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, you are not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us pray. That we pray, Almighty God, that we serve the grace by which you bring us to new life, and may always glory in your gift, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve our blessed Lord and one another. Love-filled, faith-filled weekend. Be safe outside. I'm sure there's ice all over the place. Before we go, let's say the prayer to Saint Michael. Saint Michael, the archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God.